8.5 Competitive Equilibrium Gains from Trade Allocation and Distribution. As economists, we always say competitive markets are efficient, competitive markets are efficient. But what do we mean by that? We mean that the competitive markets maximize the mutual benefits for the consumers and producers. Let me explain.
Let's focus on the benefits going to the consumers. We call that consumer surplus. Let's focus on the customer who is buying the 1,000 loaf of bread. When that customer is walking off the bakery, he must have a smile on his face. Why? Because he bought that loaf of bread for 2 euros while he was willing to pay a much higher price for that bread. So that was a surplus going to that consumer. Have you found yourself in a situation that you purchased a product and secretly you were willing to pay a much higher price for that product? That was a consumer surplus going to you. Let me give you another example. Let's focus on the customer who purchased the 3,000 loaf of bread. Again, that customer is happy when he's walking off the bakery. Why? Because he purchased a loaf of bread for 2 euros while he was willing to pay a higher price than 2 euros. But this time you see the consumer surplus is smaller compared to the previous customer. So this area represents all the surplus going to the consumers. Why? Because all the demanders here on our demand line, we're willing to buy bread, a loaf of bread, for a price higher than 2 euros, but in the end, they end up just paying 2 euros. We can think about the same concept, but from a perspective of firms. We call that producer surplus. Let's focus on the baker who's selling the 1,000th loaf of bread. That baker must have a smile at the time he's selling that bread. Why? Because he's selling that loaf of bread at a much higher price that he was willing to supply that bread. Remember, this is the supply curve, which in this case is the same as the marginal cost curve because we are operating on their competitive market. So, just to repeat, that baker is selling the bread at a much higher price that he was willing to supply that bread. And that difference is a producer surplus, a benefit going to the baker. So if we put these two sides together, we realize that when the baker was selling the 1,000 loaf of bread and the customer was buying that loaf of bread, they both benefited from these transactions. There was a surplus going to the consumer and a surplus going to the producer. However, this does not mean that both of these sides equally benefited. For instance, in the case of the 1,000 loaf of bread, you see the benefits going to the consumer is higher than the benefits going to the producer. But from an aggregate perspective, you see that the competitive markets maximize this area. They maximize the surplus going to the consumer and producers. They maximize the joint surplus. Finally, let me compare a competitive market with a monopoly market from a perspective of efficiency. Let me start with the monopoly market. The most important thing here is that we have wasted opportunities. We got a dead weight lost, which we show in this graph by this area. Now let me explain to you how a monopoly ends up hurting the consumers. At the moment, the beautiful car is maximizing their profits by charging $5,440 for each of their cars. Remember, they're pricing each of their cars the same. And they are selling 32 cars overall. And this way, they're maximizing their profits. Now let's assume we have a customer, an additional customer who wants to buy the 33rd car. And that customer is willing to pay around $4,000, let's say, for that additional car. At the same time, the cost of producing another car, the marginal cost of the 33rd car for beautiful car, is lower than the price that that customer is willing to pay. But the beautiful car never produces the 33rd car. Why? Because if they want to serve that customer, they have to lower their price for all of their cars, and they end up making less profit on the other 32 cars. And in this way, they end up making a lower total profit. Because of that, the beautiful car stops at 32 cars, and they decide not to serve that 33rd customer. And in this way, you see a wasted opportunity, a consumer benefit that was never realized. This is a good example of how a monopoly market is not efficient. Now, let me focus on the competitive market. There, you got no missed opportunities. All the mutually beneficial transactions that could have taken place between the consumers and producers have actually taken place there. There are no deadweight lost. The competitive market have maximized the surplus going to the consumers and producers. And in that sense, we say the competitive markets are Pareto efficient.